you go. Okay. So it's just this. I welcome everyone here as the I Amness, as Atman, as light, okay? You're light, first, foremost. We're dreaming right now, meaning the I Am is dreaming of all different characters, one I Am. When you have a dream at night, the whole dream arises within your mind, right? With everybody in it and you. And upon this dream, this eye says, oh, I was dreaming. But if you look at that dreaming, you look at it, it's whole. This is too, okay? In your dream at night, you're the witness of the dream. And seer and seen are one, yeah? Same thing here. Empty as a cup, safe as mother's milk. The last thing I want to do for anyone when talking about all this is create more anxiety. Anxiety is poison. It's absolute poison. It's how everything gets so jumbled up, okay? In relaxing, the mind turned out. The mind is God. Forget your mind and how you don't like it. You know, oh, I hate my mind. No, no, that one doesn't exist that hates it. And that's a creation of language, that's all. But mind, Buddha mind, is God. Where else are you gonna find God but when you're dreaming of God? In God. When the mind's turned out on objects, senses, playtime, that's the I Am now. It's not you. The you you are attached to at the moment. Okay? That's a body identity. We're going this way. You have no form right now. You're imagining your form that you're seeing as though you were the form in the dream at night. If you woke up this morning and said to me, gee, I dreamt I was over in Timbuktu with these people and they were having a problem with their car, do you think, and you said, do you think I should call somebody and send them there? It'd be funny, right? Where would you send them? Where would you send the help? From the people in your dream, right before this dreaming. You couldn't. Let's go back a minute ago. Let's rewind it. Oh, can we all do that right now? Let's go back a minute ago and find it. Where is it? Except for a notion, for an idea that a minute ago based on now, that's gone. Okay, well, from what basis are we measuring? It's always the body, rather than the witness watching. And that witness is broad, it's space-like, big, eternal. When we say that I am eternal is true knowledge, it's not true knowledge that you should believe in. Don't believe anything. That one who believes stuff isn't sure. I am eternal is what happens when you know what we're pointing at, which is right here, right now. Right now, Brahman's looking through your eyes, watching. Parabrahman's here. It's all that's really happening. I know it sounds so simple, right? It truly is. But boy, is it the whole dreaming thing for the I am. It really got caught. You didn't. Even if you say, well, my soul, that soul is universal anyway. There's no personal soul. In one consciousness, there's a person, here I am. I'm the one off. Out of all the animals, all the sentient beings, even the propriety, even the tables alive and electrically alive, vibrating. By what power? We don't know. Okay? We don't know what an atom is. Nobody does. We just named it. When you really, this is key, really key for anyone, is reasoning this out, using the intellect, like the thorn to remove a thorn. Forget the fact that you don't like the mind and its chatter and all that. Just forget that. That's the one that doesn't like the chatter is part of the chatter. I hear this a lot. You know, ignore the mind. Go this way. Bring the attention back. Don't look at media and the world. It's poison. It's untrue. It's an untruth within a magic show that's not true. You know the whole snake and the rope thing? The whole Indian thing? Well, it's a rope, and everyone sees a snake, and they run and get sticks, and they eat it. Let's kill the snake. It's just a rope. Is the snake and the rope one thing or two things? Or no thing? The rope is make-believe. The idea of the snake within the make-believe play that never appeared, right now, this stuff, which is fun for the self, but the rope is not real, and the snake. This is really good news, you know. It really is good news. You don't have to suffer, that's true. Surrendering is surrendering to the fact that you don't do anything. That's imagination within the imagination of this stream of life. That belongs to you as that. It's already yours. You imagined it not. This is just a remembering of what you already are. Everyone here. Everyone. A Buddha isn't different than a mortal. A mortal believes in death, mort. Yeah, mort, death, mortuary, and all that. That's just one that's immortal thinking it's going to die. That's what a mortal is. Nothing is manifest here. Nothing. Looks like it, I know, but not to me. You know, this isn't any kind of a belief. When reality appears, unreality is seen completely as a mirage. That it is. And the one seeing it is the only one. Not two. I want to read some stuff from Bodhidharma, a couple of quotes. Actually, there's one quote that I wanted to read for everyone here from the Yoga Vasishtha. He was a great rishi. And Vasishtha says, water in the mirage does not come into being and go out of existence. Even so, this world neither comes out of the absolute, nor does it go anywhere. The creation of the world has no cause, and therefore it has no beginning. It does not exist even now. How could it reach destruction? Okay? Now, contrast that with Ramana Maharshi, his last statement on everything. There is no creation, there is no destruction. It's true, what I'm saying. It's true, he's right. Ramana's right, yeah. They're all right. And they were all that. You're that. Thinking you're not that. That's what this is all about. The hypnosis of language. It's all the alphabet. That's why I always emphasize, you don't know anything. And at best I'll get a chuckle, like, yeah, you're right. But then the mind goes right back into its safety zone of, yeah, but I know this and that and that and this and this and that. That stuff's gonna be done anyway. You don't have to repeat the language. The talk in the head, okay, that we call the talk in the head, the self-talk, to know what to the ego. It's creating a world that's not there. It's not that there's a world and you can figure out how it's not a world. There isn't a world. There's just this, and we're back to, right? It's just this. What is this? Divine. It's heaven. It's the self. Here's another quote This is Maharaj towards the end, 1980, and November 20th, 1980, he says, the principle which can know itself is in the organism. In a worm crawling, it is there, because the worm knows itself instinctively. By listening to my talks, you will be transformed back to your original state prior to birth. Okay, that's what I'm talking about. What birth? It's true too. Your original state prior to birth. Right now, in spite of your present life, it will happen. In spite of what the mind thinks is going on, all this, that's really funny too, is like how the story of life being written by the one hand, by the ordainer. Everything's just, if it's not ordained, it doesn't happen. Only an ego thinks, well, I do some stuff, right? No. It's imagination, and it gets in the way, and impulse happens, and it the consciousness moves that way, but it's always in a state of balance. You following that? This whole universe is one organism. Think of it like that. It's one mind. It's Brahma. All right. Parabrahma knows everything. Parabrahma, Brahma, they're the same. Manifested. It's not even really manifest. It's an appearance of an appearance that we're in. If you go to Kashmir Shaivism, they say the world is as you see it. So obviously, every iteration, every ray of this absolute light that's dreaming and repeating, the I am is just repeating. However that mind sees this world, that's true for that. But meanwhile, the one that's watching is the only one here. I'm laughing. It's true. For everyone here, your whole universe, you are the creator of that, meaning you're that watching the play of that iteration of dream. That's the aloneness that I've mentioned and has been mentioned. Until you know the aloneness of this only, that's why I say the word only. And if there's only the only and no other, who really can say that there's the only except for this direct knowledge of yourself this way? Now, the thought that I heard you don't have to do that, suit yourself. I mean, you're in the middle of this amazing opportunity to know and be free of this repeated dreaming and be the knower of it fully. The blindfold can come off. Ta-da. And there's no one to be enlightened. That is enlightenment. Now, if an ego gets a hold of that, it'll say, oh, then screw it. I won't do anything because it doesn't matter anyway. I wouldn't go down that path for any amount of anything. That's like getting into quicksand to take a swim. I'll take a little dip in the quicksand. A lot of a lot of the stuff that's said in spirituals, truth gets misguided, you know. Keep it simple. Really simple. Detach. Go this way. There's a well inside you of bliss that you, I guarantee when you find it, you'll say, why didn't I do it sooner? If you're waiting for enlightenment to come in time, oh, I wouldn't do that either. That's why concepts added to concepts lead to trouble. Well, I heard this, I heard that. I want to know who heard it. If you heard it, tell me who heard it. I don't know is what you'll end up saying. So I don't know, once again, is taking control of something it has no control over. You have one thing you can do is your attention. Where you put your attention. Mind, tension out, tension back. It's wild to watch what's happening in the dream of life today. With the iPhones, and that's I am-ness totally on a binge. And it's the dreaming doesn't stop. You know, this has to be resolved or not. I'm not trying to cause any anxiety. That's not why I said that. You are resolving it. It's resolving itself right now, like that. See? Just like that. Maharaj says, language energy and vital breath energy, the breathing, should merge and stabilize. Otherwise, if you allow them to go outward, they will be dissipated. You'll lose this Shakti. By pulling it in, yoga, this idea of yoking, bringing it back, that energy now can go deep and sprout. I like animal videos too, but I mean, you know, no one wants to hear that. Well, I meditate for like, that's what you're seeking is yourself. Why wouldn't you look? Where the idea of looking, of mind looking out is a ruse of the mind. Okay, this is Bodhidharma from the year 450, which is now. Time is now, always now. How's that, right? But we'll talk in terms of ancient, all right? So it's his wake-up sermon. He says, the essence of the way is detachment. And the goal of those who practice is freedom from appearances. The sutras say detachment is enlightenment because it negates appearances. It denies that the appearances, they're not what you think it is. Buddhahood means awareness. Mortals whose minds are aware reach the way of enlightenment and are therefore called Buddhas. One drop of the I am, one ray of Atman believes that, oh, I'm going to die, and all the story in the language, the story. Another one finds it, he's a Buddha, but they're both just the I am. That's all that's here. There's no separate I am anywhere, is what I'm saying. Not two, right? Everybody here believes in Advaita, I'm sure of that. But when you really come down to what it is, it's even not one because there's no one to say one. From the point of view of the absolute, there's neither one nor two. Those are concepts. It's zero. It's no. The highest teaching is no. The sutras say those who free themselves from all appearances are called Buddhas. The appearance of appearance as appearance can't be seen visually, but can only be known by means of wisdom. The appearance of appearance as no appearance. Okay? So from here, there's nothing here. Right? You hear me say it's a vapor. I'm not being fancy, all right? I'm not. But that's what it is. That's what it is. To think it's otherwise, that's wrong. It's not that it's that and it becomes this. It's all in the mind. However the mind perceives this consciousness, this realm, it is. When you go prior to mind, to know mind, and self is revealed, you see it from the original yourself, the original. Not you as somebody. You don't have a name. You've never had a name. How's that? I don't care how many lifetimes you think you lived, you've never had a name. Everything you've heard is non-existent, Shankara. And this is good news, because this dreaming, this very lovely dreaming, blissful dreaming, is not the nightmare the ego and all the dysfunction has apparently created. You know? Okay, so he says, I'll continue. Whoever hears and believes this teaching embarks on the great vehicle and leaves the three realms. What are the three realms? The three realms are greed, anger, and delusion. To leave the three realms means to go from greed, anger, and delusion back to morality, meditation, and wisdom. Is that something I do? No. When you go back to what you are, you're already moral, you're already even-handed, it's not an affectation of a somebody. The self loves itself, okay? You ate today, right? Did everybody here eat today? Did you do that? When you eat, it's Brahman eating Brahman. The space, the dream, just moving. The five elemental play, the stuffy stuff that we appear to be floating in. So the three realms of greed, anger, and delusion are gone. Then they depend on mortals. Only somebody who believes that they had a beginning and that they're going to end would be greedy. Yes or no? Right? Or they see others. An ego sees others. I'm not judging, but an ego sees that. That's how all this got started. Maharaj said, what a fall. I agree, because this was never intended by ourself. This was an accident of identification. This mind, this beautiful mind, this brilliant mind that we all have and share, this one mind, wanted to experience itself. The aloneness wanted to experience itself. Is that a hoot? Maharaj said one time, very, very funny, he said, "So, never did so much happen out of so little." To the absolute, this was just okay. And I always joke and say it went a little sideways, yeah. But it never happened. We're talking about no creation, no destruction. Where's the sting? We're talking about self and no other. Who got harmed? We're talking about emptiness and form being the same thing. So therefore, what is emptiness? Concept. Your eternal self is right here, right now, at this satsang, daydreaming time. Stop seeking. Be. But stop letting the mind go into all these other bad neighborhoods. The sutras say Buddhas have only become Buddhas while living with the three poisons and nourishing themselves on the pure Dharma. Okay, so if greed, delusion, and anger are the poisons, why would you want to watch the news? That's all the ones that are in the dream, and God bless them, they're the one too, okay? But they're the ones that are so lost in it, and you're eating that. That becomes your food. So you're eating poisons, expecting to become enlightened. I don't care that everybody does it. That's the problem. And what I'm saying, I'm sure will not be popular with the ones who are addicted to it. I'm not trying to be popular. There's no one here that I want to impress. It's just life, this, myself. What I'm doing is helping in my own raggedy fashion, yeah? But I wouldn't do it. I don't do it. It's not like I wouldn't. And I didn't, right? I was never that involved, and it's not like it. Don't forget the story. To keep thinking about, look what happened to this one and that one, they're not there. Oh, the world's going to end. So what? It's not. Trust me, it's not, because it never started and it can't be destroyed. More anxiety. You know, it's got to go. Nourish. Make a routine. I'm not trying to be pedantic, but make a routine in the morning and at night. Gently ease yourself back and just, and don't sit and get all uptight. Am I doing it right? Just be. Sit. You know? What does he say? Let's see what Bodhidharma says here. Okay, outline of practice. Here's what he says in the year 450, before things got a little more like this, right? Many roads lead to the path, but basically there are only two, reason and practice. Not, I won't think about it and I won't do anything. That's the opposite. So, right? Because that's what everyone does. I know. But I'm saying don't. Then they hear, oh, it's destined. So screw it. I won't do anything. What? No. Now there's someone else in control again. I don't know who, but you're telling me that you're doing it. You can't tell me who it is that you say is you doing it. These are facts. I don't know anything. And I know that I don't know anything. And I'm watching all my friends who should know that they're clinging still to the fact that I know something. All knowledge is bondage. You're prior to knowledge. You are that directly. Words will never capture silence. Trying to capture silence with language won't happen. It'll capture you though. It'll gobble you up. So he says, those who turn from delusion back to reality, who meditate on walls, the absence of self and the other, the oneness of mortal and sage. Again, the mortal is just the sage or the Buddha. Everyone's a Buddha. Everyone here is a Buddha. Thinking you're not a Buddha. There's only the self, right? If we want to, I don't have to, but yeah, there's only the self. So there's a Buddha and a sage are just concepts within the dreaming of the I am-ness. So there's no Buddha. There is no Yani. It's part of the dream. Yani knows this. Yani's a name for someone who knows that there's only the only. You know? In language. You're full right now. You know, you've done everything you need right now. Full to the brim. Imagining you're not. It's like a dream within a dream. The idea of the person is in this part, the consciousness dreams. That's one. It's all there is here. I wouldn't tell these things to just anybody. All right? That's another thing. The fact that you're here was not decided by you. The one that you still think is doing things. There is no such thing as separate free will, but if you believe in that, you will reap the benefits or the, that's what keeps the wheel spinning in life. Is this tamas guna, this quality of the consciousness that says, I do this, me. And it says the body, I'm doing this, yeah? So if you do good or bad, both have to be balanced. That's how the dreaming, that keeps this life dream going. There are many in the dream that are having fun. The I am's having fun anyway. It's the whole point. This isn't, it's not supposed to be torture. It's not torture for the self. It's torture for the one who thinks it's being tortured. And when that one's let go of, it's bliss. Because the one who's doing this likes to do this. Self-love, you're that. Don't try to put it into a thought. Don't try to contain yourself in a thought. What's wrong with being silent? inside. The mind will come to a complete halt. Time will come to a complete stop. You will be where you were prior to your birth. If you were born in 1950, you'll be prior to 1948. Now, unborn. This whole dream is a child of a barren woman. It's not. I'm laughing. It's not. It has no independent existence. And the one who knows that is the one who likes to dream this, the only one. Jesus called it his father. He said, I have a little bit of what my father gave me. He said, he's the gardener, I'm the vine. We are the aggregate of the five elemental play. That's why we eat food. The whole universe is made up of the elements. We don't know what they are, but the five elements create everything in it. Atoms are intelligent, electrons are intelligent. It's permeated with intelligence. Whose? The worm, the mosquito, the elephant, the human. What are they without words? Appearances. What's an appearance without the word appearance? Now the mind has found a place where it can't go any further. It stopped. Stay there. That's home. It's home. And you've never left home, and you can never be kept from home. Okay. So welcome home. Everything's all right. Love yourself because you do. All right. Doodly do. All right. I'm gonna go and walk and all that.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
This is really good. It's all good love here. Okay? Right? Yeah. Okay. Hari Om Tat Sat.